One theory, known as the zoo hypothesis, is that aliens already know we exist, but rather than making contact, they're studying us from afar as if we were animals in a zoo.
If you imagine we go to the zoo and we're walking around and we see a bunch of giraffes, what happens if one of them turns around, looks us in the eye, and starts pounding out a series of prime numbers with its hoof? We're trying to be the galactic giraffes here.
Douglas and his colleagues believe that through TV and radio broadcasts, not to mention mobile phone towers, Earth has been leaking radiation into space for decades. This leakage is exactly what SETI look for as signs of life elsewhere. So it stands to reason that if aliens are listening, they could probably already hear us.
It's too late to hide.
We're already known in the universe.
Someone has to make the first move.
If humans were to enter a dialogue with an alien species, how would we get them to understand us? This is more than a language barrier. It's a fundamental difference barrier. Because of the enormous distances involved, we're also dealing in difficult timescales. If we send a message to a life form 1,000 light years away, it will take 1,000 years to reach them. And assuming their technology is similar to ours, we'd wait another 1,000 years for the reply.
It's almost like you get an email from someone 10 years ago and they say, yes, sounds great, but you don't even remember what it was about. This only works if it's something embraced by generations to come.